Russia has developed and launched the production of long-range strike drones in China for use in the war against Ukraine, as reported by Reuters. The Russian company Kupol has developed a drone called Harpy 3 and conducted flight tests with Chinese specialists.
Зазначила попередньо Алмаз-Антей, розробила безпілотник під назвою Гарпія 3 і провела його льотні випробування за участю китайських фахівців.
Kupol informed Russian Defense Ministry of mass production of drones. At a factory in China for use in the war against Ukraine, Chinese authorities said they had no knowledge of such projects, emphasizing strict controls over the export of military products, including unmanned aerial vehicles. Analysts see confirming the supply of Chinese drones as significant, as China has only supplied dual-use goods to Russia, not full weapon systems. Fabian hints from the International Institute for Strategic Studies. The Harpy 3 drone can add about 2,000 kilometers with a payload of 50 kilograms, according to Kupol reports. And samples of the Harpy and some other Chinese-made drone models have been delivered to the Russian Kupol for further testing. According to documents reviewed by Reuters, the Kupol received 7 Chinese-made military drones. Headquartered in the Russian city of Izhevsk, and according to 2 European intelligence sources, the delivery of the drone samples to the Kupol was the first concrete evidence that their agency had detected Chinese-made drones being shipped to Russia since the war in Ukraine began in February 22nd. Russia is secretly negotiating with the Houthis, a pro-Iranian group in control of much of Yemen, for potential anti-ship missile supplies through Iran's mediation, Reuters reported on September 25th. In July, the Wall Street Journal reported that Russia was considering providing the Houthis with Yakhont missiles, which could significantly enhance the group's attacks on American and European vessels in the Red Sea. According to Reuters sources, the final decision on the supply has not yet been made. The Houthis support the radical Hamas group, recognized as a terrorist organization by the US and EU, at war with Israel, and promising to attack Israeli allied ships in the Red Sea. Subsequently, they sank at least 2 vessels and hijacked another, causing disruptions to global maritime trade, rerouting, and increased insurance costs. Despite US strikes on Houthi positions, the threat to ships in the region remains. And Houthi spokesman Mohammed Abdel Salam said they were not aware of any possible missile deliveries. Russia's defense ministry and Iran's UN mission declined to comment, while a U.S. Defense Department spokesman warned that a strengthened Houthis could threaten international navigation and stability in the Red Sea and Middle East. Since Russia's full-scale involvement in Ukraine, military cooperation between Russia and Iran has increased, with the U.S. previously claiming that Iran transferred ballistic missiles to Russia. Russian President Vladimir Putin announced Russia's readiness to supply modern long-range weapons to opposing countries. The Yakhont is an advanced anti-ship missile. It flies at supersonic speeds and is able to glide across the sea surface, making it difficult to intercept. At the end of this hour, I will add information regarding the terror and shelling by the Russian occupiers. The Russian military struck the center of Kramatorsk, Donetsk region. It is reported that 1 person was killed, several others were wounded. I am reporting this with reference to the statement of the head of the regional military administration, Vadim Filashkin, and as reported by the head of the regional military administration, I quote, "Russians hit the city center. 2 high-rise buildings, shops, and cars were damaged," end quote. This is another war crime by the Russians, and another sad reminder that there are no absolutely safe places left in the Donetsk region. Take care of yourselves. Evacuate. At the same time, Filashkin said that 1 person was killed and 15 others were wounded in the shelling. We have updated information. The head of the Kramatorsk City Military Administration, Alexander. Two deaths have already been reported. Russian occupiers often strike at Kramatorsk. I note that in the region itself, there is now even a compulsory evacuation for children. And we ask everyone who is watching, who may have relatives or friends in the city or in the region, to pass on information and ask them, the people who are there, to evacuate, in particular if these families have small children. It is important. All our anger and hatred, as always, I emphasize, convert into donations. I remind you to support the Defense Forces of Ukraine. Here is the official QR code from Channel 24. Please scan it and go to help our defenders. They desperately need your support now.